Yo, everybody, it's your boy Devil May Care 4, my homie.
Mr. Howard, 1, 2, 3, and we have a special guest with us today.
Nikki FGC, what's going on, everybody?
What's up, buddy? So, guys, in the, you know, in the comments or viewers of this video, we're going to be going through the mainline trilogy of Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and 3 for the openings. But if you guys wanted us to check out the endings or, you know, the in between games or whatever you guys want to check out, let us check out Final Fantasy openings or whatever you guys want to let us know. Just let us know in the comments. We'll do it, you know. But right now, me, Nikki, and Roger are going to just focus on the trilogy, Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and 3 openings. So what can you tell us about this song real quick, Nikki? A little breakdown.
I think this song, compared to Simple and Clean, is a step in a different direction, where Simple and Clean had this very magical Disney sound to it. Mm-hmm. This song is definitely shrouded a little bit more in mystery. There's a lot more ambiguity in it. And for people that didn't play the game between 1 and 2, there's going to be a lot of missing elements in the trailer, and there's going to be a lot of confusion. And I think that that's what they expected as developers, that they weren't going to have people that were fully on board with the story. And we didn't know a lot about the story at the time. So everything that you see here in Kingdom Hearts 2 in the trailer with the song completely shrouded in mystery. Let's check it out.
All right, let's do it. Let's rock and roll. Buena Vista. I'm just wondering.
It's still around?
I don't even know if Windows Vista is around. Here we go.
Oh boy. Kingdom Hearts 2, baby. The crossroads. Like a far-off memory.
His voice, though. A
far-off memory that's like got some bass in it this time, yeah.
A little grown man. I want to line the
pieces up. They dropped. A little rat.
They dropped.
They dropped in the distance.
The dream drop distance.
And this is two.
Yeah.
So yes.
Two of them dropped.
Oh yeah. Okay, we're grown. We're adults, by the way. We are adults.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Little Kingdom Hearts 1 here. Little recap action. Going away from the island here, jumping into a brand new adventure.
That's cool, because literally disintegrates behind him. This is from the first game, right? Hollow Bastion?
Yeah, this is the adventure through Hollow Bastion right here, yep. Where Sora has to find Kairi and fight the big bad at the end.
It's so crazy how the beat dropped when his feet hit the ground.
Perfectly.
And that's the way I have my intro on all my YouTube videos. When the character feet hit the ground, the feet drop.
Yeah, great editing. I also love that shot right there, where in the first game he's running towards Riku with his hands out. The second game, we see that trailer, he's running to him with the Keyblade, he's ready to hit him. You know,
yeah.
It's a big contrast from the first game.
Damn, didn't even notice that. Loyalty, waiting for Sora.
Very loyal. Beautiful thing. The fireflies, these are the worlds returning at the end of Kingdom Hearts 1 once Sora and Riku defeat the big evil.
Yeah, yeah. I love that.
The time skip? Yeah, it's great. The transition?
Yeah, insane.
Long hair now, new drip.
Yeah, new drip. Same loyalty, though. Is this like the in-between game?
Yeah, right here. This is footage of Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. This is a game that came out in between Kingdom Hearts 1 and Kingdom Hearts 2. There were a lot of people that didn't get to play it because it was on the Game Boy Advance. And without playing it, you're missing a lot of key elements and a lot of important information that a lot of people didn't have playing Kingdom Hearts 2, and they're just like, who are these characters? What's going on here? But I think that's part of the experience growing up playing this game, is that not everybody played that game and they knew it.
Mm-hmm. Intentional.
They really tried their best to catch people up from the stuff that happened in between 1 and 2 during 2.
I see.
I think they did a great job.
Got him.
Scooped him up.
Yeah.
But it was for the best. It was necessary.
his hair turning blonde?
Just light. Oh, his hair is definitely lighter in this game. There's intention in that. Yes, good eye. His hair is definitely lighter in Kingdom Hearts 2 than it was in Kingdom Hearts 1.
Huh. I noticed there's that too, but I didn't want to say anything. I thought it was just the lighting.
Yeah, right. Yeah, right. No,
the streaks. Like, he has, like, the little streaks. The drop.
Boom.
And that's why it's like...
That's a good representation of it. Yeah, right there. Who's this guy? Where'd he come from? What the dog doing?
What that mouth do? What them shoes do?
Yeah, he got some big ass feet too, huh?
Yeah. I like how over the years Sora grew into his shoes, into his feet.
He did, yeah. Now he's got the lemon pepper steppers.
I like how it's an exact replica of the first opening, with the birds and the everything.
Yeah, right down to the animations.
Yeah, him looking left
and
right.
Complete parallel. Mm-hmm. And it's great writing because it's so intentional and the details of that are so important. You know, it's a beautiful thing. And like I said, listening to the music, seeing what's going on in the trailer, there's just a lot of mystery going on there. It's just,
yeah, it's kind of,
you know, completely intended.
Like this.
Rox has had more birds, though.
Two more birds?
Yeah.
You count all the birds, Rox is like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey, wait a minute. Flora had 10, Roxas has 12. What the hell? You know?
I thought it was a flying type gym.
Sheesh. But yeah, man, that was a beautiful song. It's hard to say if I like it more than the first song. I think it's just hard to compare them because it's so drastically different. But I can understand if people like this more because it's definitely more of a song like you can listen to, not just like a beat, like a. Whereas Kingdom Hearts 1 theme was definitely still a great song as and not just like music for a video game. This one feels like an actual like song I could hear on the radio, you know what I'm saying? Like for real.
Yeah. Right. Simple and Clean definitely gives you a feeling and this one gives you an emotion. They're like two different like vibes.
And
you have to also I also want to point out that the version of Simple and Clean that you hear in the intro is like the remixed version, the Planet V version with all the electronic stuff happening. The version you hear at the end, you know, we might get to that at some other point, is the original song. Yeah. So that's a very different experience too. The techno version, kind of something you listen into the car, you know, you're at the club. The other version is very comparable to this, the original version.
I didn't even know that was a thing, that there were two different versions. So that's
cool.
Oh, yeah.
I want to cover that one day for sure.
It's a slow one.
And I noticed something in the song, Nikki. Maybe you can help me understand it. There was a part where she's like, I don't know what the fuck she's saying.
Yeah, so that happens during the chorus of the song, and you'll hear these words that are spoken, and it's literally recorded in reverse. It's recorded, you know, normally, but it's reversed, and the audio is reversed. And the lyric that she says is, "I need more affection than you know." And that is warbled and distorted and backwards. And it's it's one of my favorite details in the song because of the fact that it's backwards intentionally because of how it relates to the characters in the story, like Sora having like, you know, another side, which is, you know, part of what we saw at the end there. The other character, Roxas, coming into the story is one of the main characters. It's just a great parallel. It's a great little detail that they threw in the song.
That's also like related to music not being video game music, sounding like real music, because like Missy Elliott at the time was doing that as well, like playing stuff in reverse. She did it in her song. She did it in songs she produced for Tweet. They it in Beyonce's A Gift from Virgo song.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, that reverse was very popular when this song came out.
I see. Well, awesome, guys. You know, I want to thank you, Ken, for coming by, Nikki, and, you know, giving us some information and insight on this song and this series. I appreciate that.
No problem.
Hell yeah. So also, guys, you know, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It is free to do. And make sure you check out the description below where we'll be having not just our social media links and platforms, but Nikki's as well, including his Ultra Tech University Killer Instinct School. If you guys are interested in learning that game, that is the place to do it. Trust me on this. You will get to know the game no matter what level of the game you're at. You could be brand new to fighting games, brand new to Killer Instinct, but good at other fighting games, or kind of played KI casually and, you know, just want to get better. this is the man for it. And this is the man you want to check out. We're going to have that in the description below. So,
thank you, sir.
Oh, yeah, man. All right, guys. See you guys later.
Peace.